Greetings everyone, and welcome to a follow-up video on the subject of German timber frame houses. So many people expressed curiosity and interest in this subject that I decided to make a second video to answer some of the questions and comments that had been posted on the initial video. So we're going to take a better look at the exterior of the house this time. We'll do a quick walk around, and I'm going to try and answer some of the questions people asked. While we're outside, we'll start with a question about the way the house is wired. Somebody had asked a question regarding whether the wiring in this house is modern or was improvised in some way. So you can see that up on the roof there, there's a modern satellite dish, and the power that the house draws comes from the grid. So this is fully modern in that respect. The house itself, I'm told, was actually built in 1870 or thereabouts. And as I suspected, it is indeed expanded from its original size. And in fact, it has been expanded to almost twice its original size. We'll cover that in a moment as well. But all of the interior wiring is modern. There are modern electric outlets and pretty nearly everything you might expect. And a follow-up question to that, which somebody had asked, was how is the house heated? So we'll take a quick look at the heating systems of the house as well before we move on to the structural elements. So in here is the, I guess, boiler room, but there are no actual boilers. That box over there on the left, that is a heater for water. It heats water that is then used by the house. And the one on the right there is a gas heater. It uses gas to generate heat, which is then distributed throughout a system of more modern radiators. However, for primary heating during the winter, the house uses this, which is a wood-fired furnace. And this furnace is also capable of burning coke, which is a type of coal-based fuel. So they use this during the winter, and I'm told that because the house is so drafty owing to its age and so small and cozy, a couple of pieces of wood in this furnace will heat the house to almost unbearable levels during the winter for a couple of hours, following which it will immediately drop back to freezing thanks to all of the drafts. And that hole in the floor over there, which I originally thought was for a sump, it turns out was actually cut because they are having a modern, I think they said an oil-burning furnace, installed here. So that's meant to accommodate a somewhat more evenly distributed network of heat, and I guess so that they don't roast themselves to death using the wood furnace. It bears mentioning, since this is a perfect opportunity to transition to the subject, I discussed during the previous video that the timber frames of some of these houses do not extend throughout the entire structure, and that many of them were expanded. It turns out that was the case with this house as well. Everything from this vertical timber on over that way was added much later, in I think around 1970, Filey's mother said. So this house was originally, we'll see if we can step back and take a quick look at it from afar. The gate is magnetic, by the way. Nice little convenience there. So originally, the house consisted only of the area which is timber framed up top. So that room on the second floor, the room below on the first floor, which is the living room, and that was it. It was a much, much smaller house, and let's see if we can get a better look at it from here. So this is what was original, and then that section off to the side was added later. That's a bedroom. Now, let's take another look around front, because again, I never did a proper walk around in the initial video. So let's head around this way. And another thing is that Flylee's mother is very proud of her flowers, and she was secretly hoping that I would go out of my way to show these off. So there are the flowers, a very nice piece of landscaping here and there. That bush over there, I think, is some kind of ornamental nightshade. You can see those large black berries that at least superficially resemble nightshades. And on over here, you saw these in the other video. Another thing is that this house, despite being very drafty and old, and it's very common in Germany, this practice as well, hang drying laundry, which is to save energy. Energy costs in Germany are very high. The cost of heating water, the cost of heating a house, they're very, very expensive. So in Germany, we tend to try to avoid using clothes dryers when we possibly can. And we opt instead to hang dry clothing because it costs nothing other than a little bit of extra time. So some of Filey's mother's plants here. Now, from this angle, you can see where the timber frame ends. This wall going this way, that was where the original outside wall of the house was. And then this, all of this on up, this was added much later in the 1970s. So this is, as far as I know, not timber framed. Another interesting piece of information I was given by Filey's mother is that the infill, the beige areas in between those timbers there, was originally wattle and daub, which I discussed in the previous video, is usually a framework of sticks filled in between with some sort of binder matrix like clay or mud or something along those lines. It was originally wattle and daub, but it was apparently replaced sometime later with brick. So now the building has a somewhat more modern brick infill in between the timbers there. And somebody had asked in the comments of the previous video, why would the architects leave timbers exposed? Because it would theoretically make them more susceptible to pests and weathering. I wish I knew the answer to that question, but I do not. I think it's simply that the timbers are already protected by a layer of paint or some other sort of coating. I'm not even entirely sure what types of coating other than paint would have been common in the eras in which these houses were constructed. But that is a question to which I unfortunately do not know the answer, though nevertheless a very good question. You can also see that the gutters are all new. Those are, I believe, aluminum or maybe stainless steel, a combination of both. And that's another thing I found fascinating. Let's take a look over here. I should also mention that this door was added only a year or two ago. There did not used to be a door here, but it was put in relatively recently, and in fact very recently. But in terms of efficiency and making the best use of resources at low to no cost, this system here is something that I found fascinating, and I truly admire the ingenuity behind it. These are water tanks, and let me see if I can... I cannot figure out how to open these, unfortunately. But what happens is rainwater is collected with this gutter and then empties into this tank first. There's a little... see if I can... there we go. The rainwater flows out of the gutter pipe into the tank, which will have the lid off. I should replace this here. And when this tank is full, we'll kneel down here and you can see that the left tank is at a slightly higher elevation than the right tank. So when the left tank is full, the additional water flowing in from the gutter spills over into the right tank and fills the right tank. And at the moment, although, again, I do not know how to open this tank. Filey's parents did show me inside a little bit earlier. I would have liked to show inside. Unfortunately, it doesn't seem I'll be able to. But the one on the right is full, and the one on the left is about two-thirds full. And these are, I believe, 210-liter tanks. And being that the rainwater is fresh, and in this area anyway, is very clean, It is used by Filey's family for their garden and for other similar applications, outdoor and lawn applications, that kind of thing. And the amount of money that this saves on the additional water bill, which otherwise would have been incurred for watering all of the cucumbers and strawberries and all of the other various delicious things that they grow in their garden, the amount of money saved is considerable. So again, this is German engineering, you could call it, but I think maybe just efficient ingenuity would be a better term, at work. So I think that just about covers everything. They have this this nice little spot outdoors where I'm told that they like to sit and sometimes move their grill out here. Just a lovely little spot and surrounded by a very nice hedge. So yes, I hope this has helped answer some of the additional questions that I've received in the comments of the previous video. Thank you all so much for joining me, and I look forward to seeing all of you next time. And there will be a next time, now that I know so many of you have an interest in subjects such as this one. Take care, everyone.